Hey, Michael, Dad's been out there at least an hour waiting for Santa.
Yeah, he has a special favor to ask Santa about the Bears and Browns game.
Is Santa coming?
Santa's coming, hon. Santa's coming. I know he's coming here.
I hear the sirens. Oh, there's Santa.
Oh, I knew that was going to happen. He said we had to go to work, and now he won't get to talk to Santa.
Yeah, he's going to be upset. He may talk himself out of presents under the tree.
Wow, listen to them sirens. Oh, my God.
We missed them.
Merry Christmas, Happy Hanukkah, Happy Holidays, from us at Who Gets the Game Ball. Looks like the Grinch stole the gift off our list. Some of us had dreams of a wild card game. That was painful watching the Bears blow a 10-point lead in the fourth quarter again. Three times this year. Damn. This team is far better than last year's. Not quite a top tier level, but maybe next year. Before we go any further, let's get some down-home style Bears pregame action from our friends Mark and Ray in Naperville, Illinois.
Okay, Sunday, December 17th, checking in from Naperville, Illinois. Mark and Ray doing a little Eastern European deal today here. Let's see what we got cooking. How about some kielbasa with onions and sauerkraut? We're going to make the dog pound our bitches today. Bears over the Browns, and here's a little cheer. Here we go. Go Bears.
Go Bears. Isvikata.
Isvikata. Your work is done. Time must
pass. Let's get it on. Looks good. Thanks for sharing. Let's give a big shout out to the Bears defense. They were the story. Chicago had 4 sacks and 3 interceptions. The Bears held the Browns to just 29 rushing yards. The offense was stymied. The defense set up the table for the Bears to get their points in the 20-17 loss to the Browns. It's been a few weeks. Let's hear from our friend Troy.
Browns.
Damn.
Anytime I think about Cleveland, all I can think about is when Joakim Noah was on the Bulls and he was talking about playing there and Cleveland. I've never been to Cleveland, so his thing was, nobody goes to Cleveland. Nobody's like planning on vacation. Oh, where are you going to go? Cleveland. That doesn't happen. What, the stupid Browns. They don't even have a real team. What the hell are the Browns? It's just dirt. It's a color. It's not a team. It's not a mascot. They had to come up with some fake dog. What the hell is that? Fuck the stupid Browns.
Thanks, Troy. That loss had my head spinning for a few days. There were 7 honorable mentions. Most player of the game votes go to Montez Sweat. Sweat had 7 combined tackles, 5 solo, 2 assists. He had 2.5 sacks, 1 tackle for a loss, 3 quarterback hits, and a forced fumble. Montez was a beast the whole game. Congratulations. Results, week 15. Scoring points awarded are lower value when the Bears lose. Top 5 leaderboard. Sweat jumped ahead of Komet, knocking Cole off the board. DJ Moore is still on top with 3 weeks to go. The Bears are now 5-9. Next up, the Bears play the Cardinals at home. This matchup is pretty favorable for the Bears, and any player can leap onto the board. Let us know after the game. Look for the post. Give us your Chicago Bears player of the game. Thank you. See you next time. Bear down. Merry Christmas.